And we've been waiting for this day for a long time. It's opening day at Hill and Clark Kellogg. I'm Brian Anderson. Allie LaForce is our reporter. Here's what the Houston Rockets have lined up on their schedule. On Friday, they'll go back home and will be hosting the Oklahoma City Thunder. And then on Sunday, they'll be facing Al Horford and the Boston Celtics. And we've got just enough time for a pregame report. Let's go over to the sidelines, where Allie LaForce is standing by. Allie?
BA, we've seen smaller market teams unhappy with how the buyout system has played out as of late. Agents using their leverage to get their clients to a more glamorous situation. Is it truly shifting the balance of power? That's subject to debate, guys, but these concerns aren't going away anytime soon.
Well, we'll see what comes of it, Allie. Thank you. As a player, Clark, it must be hard to keep your emotions in check on opening night.
Yeah, more of a relief than anything else, BA, especially after you've been around for a couple of years. I only played the equivalent of 5 years, so I only had a handful of opening nights, but always special. And even as a broadcaster, I think it's exciting to see the start of a new season, because that hope that everybody has is palpable.
Now the starting group for the Houston Rockets. Tyson Wood playing together in the front court. Green and Tate on the perimeter, and it's Wall in at the one. And for Minnesota, the backcourt is Russell and Edwards. Torian Prince is out there with Josh Okogie, and it's Towns in at center, filling out the middle. And down it goes, 2 points.
Really a smart look that time by Wood, giving the ball up to his wide-open teammate.
Now here's Edwards, pass to Prince. Here's Towns. Some solid D from Wood. Tate against Edwards. Wood with it. Tice outside. Clock at 6. Oh, it's blocked by Towns!
You know, one thing they can count on from Towns on the defensive end is block shots. He does not like to give up a clean look.
Here's Green. Missed it, even after all of those chances.
Hey, Jalen Green kind of started his career with a big moment, being the first player to join the Ignite team in the G League, where he got a taste of the NBA style of play.
Now here's Towns. Up top, Edwards. That one's good, and it's Towns with the assist.
Well, Edwards looking almost automatic there. Didn't wait too long to put that shot up.
Back to Wall. Tice outside. Pass to Wall. Fires the three. Gets his second attempt to go. Now he's 1 for 2. The seasoning Jalen Green picked up in the G League really did help strengthen his game.
Yeah, B.A., I mean, what a great opportunity for him to grow as a player, allowing him to continue sharpening his skills by playing against league-caliber talents.
Russell softly drops in the floater.
Well, I tell you, Russell looking very comfortable taking on aggressive defense and getting the job done. That's good focus on his part.
Wall, the pass to Tice. Alley-oop up top, hammer it home.
Gliding the pass to where it needed to be.
Wow, a strong finish to seal the deal.
And that's an alley-oop that'll be loop to loop all day long on the highlight reel.
Now here's Russell. Over Tice. Off the left rim and out. For Houston, they've gone 3 of 6 since the tip. To the paint. Pass to Wood. And he's going to the line for 2. The official saw contact while he was going up. It's going to be on Karl Anthony Towns.
And you get some traditional big man stuff from Wood. But you look at his handles, going one-on-one outside the painted area, most centers can't do all the things that he can do.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
That free throw, no good. And Wood's shown great versatility on offense. But the same skill set applies on the defensive end as well.
I mean, he can switch. He slides on the perimeter to protect the rim. His skill set is exactly what scouts are looking for now at the center position.
And the second free throw is good.
Well, playing for six teams in 5 years to start his career, Wood has certainly flipped the script. He now shows the ability to dominate over long stretches, much more consistent.
Well, since we have this break, here are the teams with the most points off turnovers last season. The Timberwolves second.
It seemed like almost every time they forced an error, they converted on it. Not just winning turnovers, but taking them to the bank.
Wall against Russell. Wall, the pass to Green. Shot is up. The Rockets with another miss.
Clearly the defense could have been better there, guys, but he also needs to convert that.
Here's Okogie. Wall covering. Pass to Towns. Here's Okogie. Just five on the clock. Shoots over Wall. It's not going to go for him. And Houston the other way now.
They ran away with this season series last year. It was one of the few teams they could beat.
And I think that's where it starts, guys. Neither team a playoff factor. But you work your way up the ladder team by team. And this is really one matchup they feel very confident in.
Now here's Russell. Okogie on the wing. Wall covering. Tate against Russell. And he can't get that one. Tice with the defensive effort. Green with the ball. Towns covering. And there's the call on Karl-Anthony Towns. That's foul number two for him. And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Reed comes in for Prince. And Beasley has subbed in for Okogie. And the Rockets making a change here as well. Gordon, he's checked in for Tice. Wood passes to Gordon. And here's Wall. Down to five on the shot clock. Edwards pulls it in.
He's looking pretty unsettled at the moment. Doesn't seem like he has a great feel for his shot.
Another miss. They desperately need a bucket. Gordon against Beasley. Gordon, the pass to Wood. We've got 1:55 left to play in the first quarter. Throws it up high. Throw it down on the lob.
Wood flying up to slam down the alley-oop emphatically.
Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
And it's blocked by Wood.
I love how they've attacked the boards here in the first quarter.
Yeah, I like the way they're setting the tone. Really playing with a lot of energy here at the start.
Now here's Gordon. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
It's been an ugly quarter for him. Trying to shoot his way out of it. Might be time to work on the playmaking skills.
Edwards against Wall. A minute four left in the first quarter here. Reed against Tate. And that's going to be a travel. Vanderbilt's checked in for the Timberwolves. Beverly comes in for Russell. All right, the Rockets making a switch here. Yeah. 52 seconds left in the first. Gordon down low. Guarded by Edwards. Shot is good by Gordon.
Boy, absolutely no rim protection, leading to a lot of easy buckets here.
Gordon against Beasley. Floats one. Reed can't hit. Houston in the lead. To the inside. Nice dish, and the layup goes down.
I just love the ball movement.
Minnesota shooting just 22% in the early stages of this one. And here's Edwards. Hey. tries to snap the cold streak. The shot off that time. The first quarter concludes, and a double-digit lead on the scoreboard. Rockets ahead, leading by 10. Quarter number two coming up right after this break. Don't go anywhere. And no question, John Wall at his best attacking the rim. But he said when his shot is falling, it's a whole different ballgame.
When my jump shot is going, it opens up the floor so much more for me and my teammates and giving those guys open looks. And it's just the hard work I put in and these guys trusting and believing me of being able to knock down open shots.
And Grant, over his career, Wall, frankly, hasn't been the most efficient scorer.
Yeah, he really hasn't. I mean, a tremendous playmaker, but his jump shot is pivotal. If he gets that dialed in, it could really help his game.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. All right, what do you think about the Rockets?
Give it up for their D. They're battling, communicating, and coming up with key stops.
They've got them rattled. It's only the first quarter, and already they've made enough big plays on defense to last really an entire game.
Filling out the wings, Beasley and Edwards. Jared Vanderbilt out there with Naz Reid. And it's Beverly in at the one spot. So that's the Timberwolves five. Reid, and a nice finish on the layup.
It's never easy trying to keep him off the glass. He's an absolute beast down there.
And about a minute gone in the second quarter. Edwards against Gordon. Perfect night so far, two for two.
Defensively, they've got to get more bodies in the paint. That's three straight field goals from below the free throw line.
Time now to hear from our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Thanks, BA. The Minnesota Timberwolves and their sister franchise, the Lynx, under new management, or at least that's the plan starting in 2023. A key part of the sales agreement was stipulation that the teams remain in Minnesota, something that's got to make the fans in the Twin Cities very happy.
Well, that's great news, Allie. Thanks for that. Now here's Edwards. Great D that time from Nwaba.
You see the explosive athleticism of Edwards. I mean, it's on full display and quite obvious. He's one of the best athletes in the league, no doubt.
And the basket by Wood.
Very little resistance around the rim right now. That's the fifth straight bucket they've given up in the paint.
Those looks they're allowing are almost automatic.
Here's Edwards.
Green.
Driving inside. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair. And that athleticism, it's what made Edwards the top pick in 2020.
Yeah, he's got a high ceiling, Brian. I mean, he lifts off with ease and power. It's rare that you have a guy who elevates like that and is strong in the air. And you definitely don't want to see him coming at you in the paint because he can wreck the rim with the best of them.
And he makes a first.
The first overall pick of the 2020 draft, Anthony Edwards, was one and done in college, entering the league at the ripe age of 19.
Prince has checked in for the Timberwolves. Okogie comes in for Beasley. Tice has checked in for the Rockets. Augustine comes in for Gordon. And he makes both free throws. Well, a surprising stat, Clark. The last two seasons, for the first time in league history, guards scored more points in the paint than centers or forwards.
How amazing is that, B.A.? What a transformation we've seen in the game at all levels, but particularly the NBA. Things have been inverted. It used to be you threw the ball inside to get high percentage shots. Now this is primarily a drive and kick league. Drive for the rim or shoot threes.
Edwards can't hit. For Houston, they've gone 2-4 here in the second quarter. Outside Augustine. Porter against Beverly. Here's Tice. Outside Nwaba. Here's Porter. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
It is. I mean, no reason to back off and give him the layup. I mean, much better off making him go to the line.
All right, guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Rockets?
They've pounded the ball inside in the first half, forcing the defense to collapse. That could free up shooters going forward.
The other thing they've had going for them tonight is their passing. I mean, doing a nice job. Plenty of their points early on coming off assists.
And some changes here for the Timberwolves. Karl Anthony Towns has checked in for Vanderbilt, and Russell is subbed in for Edwards. Tate's checked in for the Rockets. Green comes in for Porter Jr. That's also good, so he hits both free throws. For Minnesota, they've gone 1-for-6 in the second quarter. Not great. Beverly with it. Down low. Here's Towns, and he's in the books. Now 1-for-2.
Well, that's good work by Prince there, spotting the open man and then putting the ball on target on time right in the shooting pocket.
And it's Augustine off the drive. Banked it in off the glass. Augustine's got his first points in this one.
And despite the height disadvantage, oh my, he just attacks that interior.
You know what, guys, honestly, I didn't think he'd win that battle. I mean, that's a lot of height to give up.
Now here's Russell. Here's Towns. And he buries that one. Back rim it in. Towns has gotten 4 this quarter.
Towns so capable of hurting you from the mid-range area, the defense can't afford to back off of him.
And he lobs it up to the rim. Up high and down it goes on the lob.
And the lead increases on a crazy offensive sequence.
Man, the dunk alone would have been incredible, let alone the fact that it came off a 10-point pass.
Boy, I tell you what, they've got this team just a step away from being completely sleek.
They really have a commanding lead, not just in points, but in rebounds as well.
And what I like about it, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it, gritty and rough, but that's how you win games.
Now here's Beverly. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
Boy, I love the aggressive mindset Beverly has. I mean, that's really what makes him special. He's not afraid of getting bumped, especially when he's going to the bucket.
And the NBA and its players taking an active role socially. Grant, talk about what you're seeing now and how it registers with you.
Well, you know, it's exciting, it's inspiring, it's patriotic. It's what America is, being able to exercise your voice and helping to form a more perfect union. So that's what it's all about, and I'm excited for the league and its players, and it's inspiring, like I said.
The first one falls.
And you know, Beverly is easily one of the most tenacious defenders in the league, an absolute pest of epic proportion. Love his energy.
John Wall, he's checked in for Martin. Both shots good from the stripe.
And they seem to have taken a more heads-on approach this quarter, and it's getting them to the free throw line.
Yeah, I don't think it's an accident that aggressiveness correlates with playing better. So the aggressiveness is starting to pay off.
They're finding ways to get the ball into the paint. 5 consecutive buckets.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
Now here's Beverly. Right side, Russell. Shoots over Wall. The shot by Russell, no good.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
The Timberwolves shooting only 25% from the floor. Not great. Here's Okogie. Tice defending. 13 feet out. It's tipped! And they get it back. The Rockets have gone 5 of 10 in the second quarter. Here's Wall. It's hauled in by Beverly.
You know, it hasn't been his best outing, but they still find themselves in the driver's seat here.
Pass to Russell. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair.
And D'Angelo Russell, looking at his career, he's slowly becoming a more efficient player, learning his strengths and his limitations.
That free throw misses. Some changes for Minnesota. Reed comes in for Okogie. And Beasley has subbed in for Beverly. Woods checked in for the Rockets. Gordon comes in for Augustine. And he can't hit the second.
You know, Russell's known for his scoring ability, but I like the fact that he's eager and hungry to continue to improve.
The 15-footer. And Wood with the stuff.
And I just love how he's making the effort plays that everyone around him appreciates.
It is certainly making an impact tonight.
Well, you know, if you're not going to take care of the defensive glass, it's going to be hard to come away with the win.
Here's Prince. The Rockets getting their last shot to go. Here's Russell. Got a piece of it. 3 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Tate passes to Wall. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way. That one on Russell.
Wall figures out ways to draw fouls and turn those into points. He is a dynamic point guard.
Shooting two.
He's off on the first.
Boy, what a comeback by John Wall. He went 2 years between games after that Achilles injury suffered in 2018. Really good to see him back.
Good on the second one. There's 10 seconds left in the first half of this game. Russell, the pass to Reed, and he banks in the layup. Reed's gotten his second bucket.
Good, solid execution inside. That's exactly the look you want.
And so it's Houston in a good situation, up by 13 points to close the quarter. They put in work down low, getting in close and scoring in bunches. And don't go far. We'll be right back.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Houston holding the upper hand after the first two quarters. They have a 13-point lead. And Shaq, let's get your input on the Rockets.
They wouldn't be ahead without the numbers they've gotten from the bench, providing major contributions, especially at the offensive end. It's taken a lot of pressure off the starters. What a luxury to have a second unit that can produce.
And Kenny, how about you? What'd you see from the Timberwolves?
Well, the best way that they can get back into this game is to show up their rebound. They need to prevent second-chance points and fight. I mean, fight to get their own. If they could do that, this game's still within reach.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Christian Wood with a strong contribution so far in this one.
Yeah, they've done an amazing job of creating room to operate for him. And then, of course, executing.
And you know what? It helped that they had a few guys with very hot hands on the perimeter, too.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly in the second. So, on the floor for Houston. Green and Tate on the perimeter. Tyson Wood playing together in the front court. And it's Wall in at the point. Here's Towns. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a three-point play.
Shooting one.
And you look at Towns. He's been a fantastic outside shooter since coming into the league. It's a hallmark of what makes him so dangerous. He can do it inside, but he's a lethal jump shooter as well.
Find the lane. Find the lane. One shot.
And with Towns and his shooting, he's actually the Minnesota franchise leader for made threes.
How about that? Took over that record, B.A., in 2021. Amazing on several levels, no matter how you look at that stat. The fact he's 7 feet and the fact he did it so quickly, mind blown.
Now here's Green, six on the shot clock. Here's Tice. Okogie pulls down the board.
Boy, he knows he should have knocked that one down, especially with the defense not giving much of an effort.
Here's Russell. Had a chance there to cut it to single digits, but it's off target. Well, Houston's shooting 41% in this game. Towns against Wall. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Wall's got 8 points.
Boy, you love Wall's tenacity there. Takes the contact and finds a way to finish through it.
And if you're just joining us, we played just over a minute here in the third. Pass to Russell. Knocked away. Stolen by Wall. Back comes Houston in transition. Here's Tice. And good. Coming on the assist by Wall. Tice has gotten his second bucket on the night.
You know, John Wall is not just a dynamic scorer. He is outstanding at sharing the ball with his open teammates.
Here's Prince. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line. That one on Tate.
Shooting two.
And he knocks down the first one.
Been a bit of an odd start for Taurean Prince in his NBA career after being selected 12th overall in 2016. He was part of a three-way deal that sent him to the Hawks.
Nwaba, he's checked in for the Rockets. Both good from the line that time.
It's not luck that he's so steady at the line. It's through repetition and hard work.
Outside Wall. And he's going for the oop here. And finished off by Tice.
Woo! I just love that alley-oop slam, B.A.
Defense disorganized. Defense pays.
Boy, I tell you what, guys. This is really getting close to being real ugly.
Now here's Russell. Towns finds Edwards. Shot clock at six. Pass to Okogie. The Timberwolves need to get off a shot here. And it's going to be a 24-second violation. They turn it over. Let's take another look at the staunch defense during that mobile one block.
Yeah, just some terrific effort there. And you know the whole team will get an energy boost off a block like that one.
Beverly, he's checked in for the Timberwolves. Martin, he's checked in for the Rockets. For Houston, they've gotten 3 of 4 shots to fall so far in the third. Outside Nwaba. Now here's Tice. Pass to Wall. And here is Green. And it's in after a nice bounce off the right iron. And the Rockets lead by 16.
And just totally relentless, only increasing the intensity level.
Yeah, I love the fact he doesn't play the score. He just keeps coming, attack mode. He doesn't know how to step off the gas pedal.
Here's Towns, got a hand on it.
And they're plus 5 on the boards after that rebound.
Hey, yo, yo, Rockets. Now here's Wall. He's closely guarded. Rebound Minnesota. Towns has got 5 rebounds in the game. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the third quarter. Here's Edwards. It's wide right, hits off the rim.
Only 20% from the field to start this half. To me, it looks like their opponent may have made some nice adjustments.
So it'll be two free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. And Wall really helps you across the board.
He fills up the stat sheet at both ends, but he also has that presence, that it factor. Whether winning or losing, his confidence never wanes.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
And that one falls for Wall.
And, you know, Wall himself has said, my jumper is the key thing. Whether in pick and roll or on the break, defenses force him to knock down shots.
All right, the Rockets making a switch here. Gordon's checked in. So he picks up just one from the line that time. And you watch Wall shoot the ball. Man, he is consistent with his mechanics.
Yeah, you know, he's got that one motion release, B.A., and gets rid of it pretty quickly. Can still carry your offense in stretches when he needs to.
Screen coming.
Here he goes. 2 points. That one goes. Gordon's got six.
Just so successful getting the ball inside and finding those great looks.
Beverly, the pass to Edwards. Oh, he can't stop the run as that misses.
And his struggles have been apparent, unable to make an impact scoring the ball.
Wall with it, picked up by Reed. Back to Martin, puts up a three. And the basket's good with the assist from Wall. Wall's got five assists in the game.
The assist numbers certainly stand out. They've really emphasized ball movement here today.
Clearly just an example of a different mindset between these teams.
And Minnesota calls time here.
Protecting the rim has to be their top objective right now.
Yeah, you know, just look at the numbers, guys. I mean, they are being taken to the woodshed in the paint.
Porter Jr., he's checked in for the Rockets. Augustine comes in for Wall. And here's Edwards outside. The Timberwolves again can't hit.
It's obvious they're becoming frustrated. Nothing seems to be going their way.
You know, guys, no denying it's been a rough patch here. I think they've got to run whatever is best in their playbook to get a good shot.
And an emphatic jam on the lob.
They're really dictating the tempo on both ends of the court. You love it.
And don't leave out the coaching staff here now. I mean, their game plan has been perfect.
All right, let's check in with Allie LaForce.
So, Brian, the NBA tests out different rules in the G League, including shooting one free throw for all the possible points to speed things up. How much did it hurt players' free throw percentages, not getting the multiple tries? Well, averages dropped a percentage point or two. Is that a deal breaker or something to consider?
Yeah, those are good questions. We'll see, Allie. Thank you. Beasley, the shot no good. Great D that time from Nwaba. And it's Augustine off the drive. Pass to Porter. Off target from outside. The Timberwolves shooting just 24% in this one. Not great. Beasley outside. Over Nwaba. They get it again. Reed, good. Reed's got 8 points.
Second chance points are always painful. Have to make the effort to box out.
Hey, guys standing around spectating. I mean, you got to get in there and get tough.
Now here's Gordon. He has six. It's Beasley on the wing. We've got 33 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's Reed. Rockets with a rebound. The biggest lead of the game was 24 points. Here's Porter. Reed with the rebound. Reed's got four rebounds now. Here's Beasley. And it's Martin with the rebound. Martin's got his fifth rebound in this one. Pass to Nwaba. Oh, and Reed with a block. That'll count. Oh, and the release was before the buzzer, but it's off target. And so it's Houston. They have a confident 20-point lead right now. Their defensive efforts have paid off, effectively shutting down the opposing offense. More 2K action in just a moment. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm Assist of the Game.
This is the definition of team chemistry. I love to see this kind of communication and connection between teammates leading to the perfect pass.
For me, next to the big-time alley-oops and monster throwdowns, passes like that are probably the next best thing when it comes to sweet-looking NBA highlights.
And one quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. Russell the one, Beasley the two. Karl Anthony Towns is out there with Naz Reid. And it's Okogie in at the three, the small forward. So that's the Timberwolves five. Now here's Beasley. Pass to Towns. Back to Beasley. Here's the three. That's in. Coming off an assist from Towns. Beasley's gotten himself on the board with a three there.
You know, with his ability to space the floor, Beasley adds a strong dimension to his team's offense.
Here's Porter. Some solid D from Beasley.
Trying to close out. You got to know who's hot and who's not.
And we played through about a minute here in the fourth. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
You know, as young as Malik Beasley is, it's really been impressive to see how quickly he's adapted to the pro game. For some guys, it's a struggle, but I think he found his footing fairly easy.
All right, well, a look at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for Houston.
I like how they've taken the high percentage shot in the paint. In the first half, we saw them doing it, and they've continued to succeed as the game has worn on.
They've also jumped on any opportunity they've had to attack the basket tonight. I mean, excellent penetration.
Prince has checked in for Reed, and the Rockets making a change here as well. Green's checked in for Augustine. He hits the second from the line.
They're finding a rhythm from the line as they try to cut into this deficit.
Houston in total control. Outside Porter. And stolen by Beasley. Outside Russell. Pass to Prince. Back to Russell. Here's Okogie. Defended by Gordon. Just five to shoot. Here's Okogie. He can't get that one to fall. Some solid D from Wood. And we've made our way through just over a minute and a half of this fourth quarter. The drive by Porter. No good there. Now Minnesota takes it the other way. They'll be playing host to New Orleans for their next one. It'll be the second of three straight games on their home floor. Beasley against Green. Up top Beasley. That's tipped. It's stolen by Green. Here's Porter. Sweet little floater. Porter's got his first 2 points of the night.
The floater can be a tricky shot, but that's the right choice.
Fourth quarter play. We're about 2.5 minutes through it now. Here's Towns. Ooh, the lead pass was in the perfect spot to set up the layup.
Towns attacks the basket with such a ferocity and never give up attitude. I love that about him, guys.
Here's Gordon. That one is off. Now Minnesota takes it the other way. We're in the final quarter play here. 3 minutes in. Here's Okogie. Over to the wing. Five to shoot. Here's Russell. It's rebounded by Houston. Wood's got 12 rebounds here tonight. Big time effort. Here's Gordon. And the layup is good off the glass. And the Rockets lead by 18.
And Gordon can go either guard position. He's a combo, thanks mainly to his remarkable handles. Hey, yo,
right here. Pass to Prince. Inside. Here's Towns. And that one's good.
Boy, he's doing everything he can. At this point, the rest of his teammates need to step up and give him some help.
Timeout called. Houston.
Adjustments are a part of every game and every quarter of a game. I think Coach sees something here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
And now a moment to present the New Balance Player of the Game, John Wall.
Can you say vintage? Wow, this was a vintage performance. I mean, so much of the game is about the three ball today, but his focus was going hard into the paint and doing damage from inside.
This here was a gutsy performance from him in front of a tough crowd. The fans were on his back, and it never got to him. If anything, it motivated him more. Now here's Wall. And the bucket counts, and he is on his way to the line. He'll try to make it a three-point play. Falls for Wall. For Minnesota, they've gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. To the middle. Here's Prince. He can't hit that time. Tice with the defensive effort.
They've had a slight leg up on the boards and a big leg up on the scoreboard.
Well, you take a look at all of the stats, the team stats, that is, and that's one of the many areas that they've had the advantage. And as a result, they've got a big lead.
Now that's how you use the screen right there.
And it leads to a thunderous finish. That was nice.
And, you know, not enough help from the defense there to compensate. He gets a clean look, and that's exactly how you draw it up.
Tries to break his ice. Rockets with a rebound. Now Wall. Well, back in 2017, the league adjusted the odds to the lottery. How do you like the change?
I really love it. I mean, instead of drawing the top three, it's now the top four, adding to the randomness and giving another team a chance to be in that mix for the top pick. And evening out the odds has produced some shockers, too. New Orleans getting Zion was one of them. You know, of all the things Okogie does well, his passing tends to get overshadowed at times. I mean, easy to see how creative he is on this feed.
Wall gets the bucket.
Defense all over him. Still gets the finger roll to fall.
And Minnesota calls time here. They're down by 21. We've got a minute 48 left to play in the fourth. And the Timberwolves going with a whole new group out there. We've got a minute 48 left to play in the fourth quarter. Pass to Reed, down low. Here's Miller. Now here's Reed. Here's Noel, six to shoot. Here's McLaughlin. Misses the three.
And you can see how scary this team can be when everything is clicking for them. Just a terrific performance for the Rockets.
They had excellent production from the bench.
This team has strong depth, and in this game, it showed.
And so this win marks their first victory of the new year.
Always good to start a season series off with a W. They showed tonight they take this team seriously, and the next two matchups between these two should be fun.
Yeah, I don't think it'll play out quite that simply, though. The team coming out on the losing end of game one is just that much more motivated to get even in game two and three. So I think the edge goes to the losing team.
And no question this was a team effort, but you have to love how big a night this was for John Wall.
Well, you have to marvel at how well he picked apart that defense repeatedly, found the right guy in the right spot at the right time.
Here's Garuba. Outside Nwaba, pass to Garuba. Here's Augustine. Off the mark there with a three. Here's McLaughlin. He's covered by Augustine. Here's Reed. From 13, another miss by Minnesota. Outside Augustine. And so Houston takes this one by a big margin. This one wasn't even close. The hometown crowd was waiting for a miracle that never came.
Yeah, and this team was consistent throughout. They met every challenge, and they earned this dub.